Again, these will be compounds consisting of carbon, oxygen, in the order we usually do, hydrogen and oxygen. All right. Now, in the case of oxygen, what does oxygen do, do you think, to the equivalent, being a divalent compound? It gets ignored because it doesn't bring anything in the process. Let me show you. It actually can sit between hydrogens. Let's say you have oxygen adds two bonds rather than three. So as a result, the formula equivalent for the unknown will ignore oxygen. So we don't count oxygen, we just ignore it and write it with its straight order of hydrogens. For example, if you have a compound that has a CC like this, and we have hydrogens over here, we put an oxygen between it. Going to affect the number of hydrogens on that compound? No. It didn't add or subtract. It's just sitting between those two points. Let's say we put an oxygen between a C and an H. All right, what's it going to do? Well, again, did I add anything in the way of hydrogen when I did that? No. I just simply put it between them, so I didn't increase or decrease the number of hydrogens associated with that formula equivalent. So let's say I have another compound in this case of this form. So I have a C5H8O compound. What would be the hydrocarbon equivalent for that compound?
C5H8.
Now, what's the parent compound formula?
C5H12.
H14, right? 2N plus 2, right? Now, I would simply just take then my H12 minus H8 for my unknown, right, equivalent formula, divide it by 2, and you'll get 2 degrees of unsaturation in. Okay? Everybody see how we treat those there? Mm-hmm. So, nitrogen then, we subtract the hydrogen to write the formula of equivalent hydrocarbon for the unknown, and then for oxygen, we just simply ignore it, and in the case of halogens, it replaces it. So, halogens count as hydrogen in the unknown equivalent formula. Okay. Now, what if you get a mixed up compound? Just apply a rule to each one, all right? Just apply all rules to it in that order. Let me see if I can make up one that would make sense. Well, I don't have to make sense. We can just do it absolutely. I might get a screwed number if I'm not careful. Let's say we had a C5H11ClO compound. We don't have to write a structure for it, but let's just do it from the formula. What would be the equivalent then for the unknown of this particular compound? C5H12. How did you get that? Alright. Chlorine just adds 1 to the number of hydrogens. Oxygen doesn't count. It doesn't add or subtract anything, right? So that would be the equivalent formula of the hydrocarbon. What would be the degrees of unsaturation? C5H12 would be the saturated form, so I have 0 degrees of unsaturation in this case, right? So there's one that has no unsaturation associated with it. All right, everybody good with that?
Of course.
Of course. Yeah. Now, what good is it? At this point, it's just a lesson to show you how I can look at hydrogen.